You know, there's a nice moment that just lingers on me. And it just holds on me. You know what I mean? And I feel like maybe that's what the audience will want to come back and revisit. Sure. First met, you know, doing the training, really. I mean, some of these guys knew each other and some of them have known each other for a long time. But for me, you know, I really got to meet all these guys when we showed up and did the military training. And I think that was a good way to do it because, you know, we were all distracted by trying to figure out, like trying to, you know, be good at our job and figure it out and, you know, impress the trainers and stuff, which I'm not sure we did. But it was a good way to sort of build camaraderie, I guess, get started.
And I've known Charlie for 15 years. We've been great pals, and Oscar for 10 years. This is our third film. So it was kind of a dream situation to have, you know, two of your best pals go off and you know, sort of run and gun in these beautiful locations, have a great script, have a story about camaraderie, brotherhood. So it just kind of came natural.
Well, we had some amazing an opportunity to work with some pretty extraordinary guys that had a long history of operating in the special forces at a very high level. There were three SEAL team members and a Delta Force operative, and so you know, getting exposed to that level of excellence, you know, really gave us a clear indication of what we should be aspiring to, you know? And it was amazing. I mean, they really threw us in the deep end. I was quite surprised by the level of trust that they put in us. And I realized that was, you know, by no accident, you know, it was very carefully thought through because, you know, we had a limited amount of time for them to instill the seriousness of, you know, of what that job is. And so, you know, the day that we met, we were out on the range doing live fire exercises, you know, so that I think pretty quickly focused us into what was required.
Patience, none. And rain, maybe a little bit, or a little bit better with a mule. I think something that was interesting is that we also all individually trained in specific ways for what the characters required. There was, you know, the overall, you know, kind of almost more, I thought of it as mental training that we all had from these guys. I think that's what was particularly special, just the way they approach problem solving. But then I think individually we all had different requirements. And so for me, one of the things was high altitude training because I knew I had to do this chase sequence with Adria in Colombia, where it's, you know, quite high, almost like 4,000 meters, and that was an interesting thing to, you know, train with masks and in certain rooms where they would mimic the level of altitude. So I don't know if I retained any of that, but at the time I was pretty good.
You still operate at high altitudes?
Not sure I can.
You still got the mask.
Yeah.
My character, when you meet him, he's an MMA fighter, so weeks prior to the shoot, there was a lot of...
Me choking you out.
Yeah. Jiu-jitsu, MMA stuff, and just the physical aspect. I mean, these guys are all at sort of different places in their retired careers as special forces, and, you know, my character was one that kept it up by, you know, fighting MMA, so kind of focused on that, plus the tactical stuff.
Swimming with mules, I would say, is
it's going on the
something
TV.
That I really, you
trained
know,
for weeks.
Became pretty proficient.
And you can use
at.
That, I mean,
you
all
know,
over the place.
All, you know, it's amazing.
Applicable anywhere.
Yeah.
I was glad.
We were shooting in Hawaii, so it was pretty cushy. No, it was really amazing. I mean, that was one of the really exciting parts of this is that, you know, we got to go to a lot of extraordinarily beautiful places. We were in Oahu, and then we went up to Northern California to Mammoth, and then to Bogota. So, you know, I mean, there were a couple of. There were a couple of long, wet nights, but apart from that, it was a pretty beautiful place and fairly easy place to be shooting in.
Well, I think the scene that I definitely thought about the most, that JC as a director talked about the most in terms of kind of what his expectations were, and it was very much in the script, was that they, in the scene of the raid on the Larea's mansion, you know, over and over again, we were kind of brought to understand, like, he wanted us to see us flow as one unit. Here's where we're going to see the research manifest itself. Here's where we're going to kind of show the audience that the sort of verisimilitude of what we were doing. And so that was done in a kind of painstaking way, and it was very thoroughly kind of rehearsed and choreographed, and we hopefully we got across that kind of that feeling that these are these men are a unit who have worked together for a long time. Yeah.
It seems like there's always a pretty huge reaction when the mule falls off the cliff. Like that's a pretty big one.
They want to watch that one over and over,
over and over again.
You know, there's a nice moment that just lingers on me. And it just holds on me, you know what I mean? And I feel like maybe that's what the audience will want to come back and revisit.
Sure. A lot of pausing.
It's a lot of sort of middle distance, like, what's out there? You know, that moment. Mm-hmm. Just a suggestion.
Yeah. The algorithm will pick up on that, for sure.
Thank you.
I have a feeling that what you just saw is, you know, my rules.